back. That was a long commercial break, wasn't it? I'm very glad you're back. Very glad you're back. And I hope you enjoyed the products advertised. My first guest tonight stars in the hit CBS series The New Adventures of Old Christine, which is Mondays at 8:30. Take a look at this.
If a man's sperm makes its way upriver and one gets through, then you get a baby. If not, the woman gets her period. And the period can last for quite a long time. In some cases, the entire length of a marriage.
I'm giving him the talk. Hey, sweetheart, here's your book bag, okay? Now, don't forget, I'm picking you up at 2 o'clock outside school.
Okay.
Okay, lovey, have a great day. Love ya.
Bye, Mom.
Bye, darling. Yeah. Let me tell you, I had plenty of sexual complaints. He used to work it like he was scratching a lottery ticket. Let me tell you, there were no instant winners there.
Julia Louis-Dreyfus, everybody. Julia, Julia, welcome.
Good. Craig.
You look sassy this evening.
Thank you.
I haven't seen you in yellow before.
I haven't seen myself in this either.
It's very lovely.
It's Easter. It's my Easter look.
Really? Okay.
No, not really.
It's Friday the 13th.
Well, that's a good day for me.
Really?
When's I was born on Friday the 13th.
Really? Well, is it your birthday today?
No.
No.
In January.
Right. Oh, yeah. January, the Friday the 13th.
Yeah.
Do you associate with bad luck then?
Well, I mean, I worship the devil.
So this is kind of like a big day for you and your people then.
Yeah, it's a big celebration. Yeah.
Right. Okay. Yeah. Are you a superstitious person?
Yes.
Really?
Are you?
Well, very, very. Compared to me, most people are just stitious.
What are you superstitious about?
I wear lucky underpants.
Have you got
any lucky underpants? Because I'll wear them if you have them. My thing is, I don't wear my own lucky underpants. I wear other people's lucky underpants. That's what I think is lucky. Well, it's lucky for me.
I don't think you're superstitious. I think you're a pervert.
That's right. That's right.
How about that?
How about that? You sassy yellow thing. Do you believe in the Seinfeld curse? There's another thing. Do you believe in that?
Oh, yeah, I believe.
No, come on. You won an Emmy right off the bat with the old Christine thing.
Yeah, that was good. And of course I don't believe in that curse, and it was very exciting to win that Emmy.
Yes, you didn't say, I was at the Emmys that, I didn't win an Emmy.
Hmm.
Yeah,
you didn't come and say hi to me either.
I did. Yeah, yeah, I did.
No,
yeah,
you didn't.
You know, there was a lot of people around you.
Oh, you know what? And I was so drunk.
Yeah, you were. You were. I actually lost to Barry Manilow, who was in my category.
Oh, right.
Yeah,
I remember that.
Because all you guys.
I do remember that. Yeah.
Yeah. Because all of the guys that won Emmys, they go off to a certain area that's for winners, and everyone else goes to a certain area for losers.
Yeah, they go to the loser section.
The loser, and I was in the loser section as well.
Yeah. Well, believe me, I've been in that section many times.
Do you bet on yourself?
I don't bet on myself. I wonder if that's illegal.
I don't know. Depends. Do we go out in Nevada? If we go out in Nevada, everything's cool.
No, yeah. I don't bet on myself, but my husband actually did bet on me.
Really? To win?
To win, and he won a lot of money.
Really?
Yeah, he won a lot of
money. That's very nice.
Yeah.
But he only
called me after I won. He came up and he said, I put down a lot of money.
For you to win?
Uh-huh.
Right. Because if he'd put down money for you to lose, he wouldn't have told you.
Well, he would have been hedging his bets.
Exactly. Which, of course, no gambling man ever would.
Don't ask me.
Yeah.
I have no idea.
The last time you were here, you were nervous because you were going to host Saturday Night Live. Now you've done it twice.
What do you think about that?
Yeah, it's excellent.
Yeah, very. I was. I was terrified. And now I was still scared the second time I went. It's really scary. It's so live.
But you were a cast member on Saturday.
I know, but still, when you're hosting it and you've got to do a monologue and you've got to, you know. And
all it must be terrifying. Wow, we're doing a monologue and hosting. Oh, you poor thing. Yeah,
right.
Every night of the damn week.
Well, this is live, though, man. It's
live. Well, that's just live. Look, it's dark outside. Yeah, live is scary, isn't it? Live. You could just say the wrong thing and ruin your career, just like that.
Oh, don't say that.
Well,
I'm
just
saying.
Don't
even say it. It's
so scary. That's what I worry about every night out here as we go live.
You're a brave soul.
I am a brave soul. It's true.
Yeah, all right.
Do you get nervous? Do you do little superstitious things before you go on? You, like, walk around twice and wear your lucky underpants? I'm back to that, obviously.
No, I don't have OCD, if that's
right,
what you mean.
Right,
no,
right.
But I do have certain superstitions, but not before performing. Oh, actually, I do.
Really?
Yeah, but see, now I can't tell you what it is.
See, now that's superstitious. If you can't tell me what it is, that's also a superstitious thing.
Right, so there you go.
Yeah.
There's one.
Do you think you're mentally healthy?
I think I'm, I think I'm nuts.
Wow. Wow, really?
Are we live?
Well, luckily we're live, but... but we can get someone to the button and the pixelating machine. You know, the thing is, we have to pixelate that so we don't even look like, it doesn't even look like you said it. You know what I love, though? A woman in a yellow dress that talks like that. Meow!
I'm like a sailor.
You're like no sailor I ever met, lady. I tell you. Well, actually, you're like one.
Yeah,
but that
right.
was Amsterdam.
I like this show.
Yeah, yeah. Well, we got to take a break, though. We have to take a commercial break. We'll be right back with Julia Louis-Dreyfus, everybody, when we come back. Fancy Moses. You got the moves. Do you ever watch the old Seinfeld reruns when they're on?
Not a lot. I mean, you know, it's on all the time, so my kids watch it sometimes.
Really?
And, well, yeah, my 14-year-old's starting to get into it a little bit.
Right, okay.
You know, then I walked in on him watching the contest one, and I had to turn that off. No, I said, you know, don't watch this anymore. This show's a piece of crap. Don't watch it.
Yeah, the whole series, it's a show not about anything, except that episode, The Contest. That was about something, wasn't
sure
it?
It was about something, yeah.
Are you speaking at your old school? Is that right?
Yeah. I went to Northwestern University, and
is that swanky? I don't know. Is that good?
Yeah, Trey Swank.
Yeah, Trey Swank.
I'm going back to be the commencement speaker, and I am terrified.
Really? Well, wear the yellow dress and use that word you used earlier. You'll be great.
Maybe you'll write it for me.
Well, I could write a speech along those lines. Yeah, I'm sure.
Yeah.
What are you going to say to the kids? What are you going to tell them?
I don't know
them?
What I'm going to tell. Let me tell you something. Last year, you know who their commencement speaker was?
Who?
Barack Obama.
Yeah.
Exactly, right? What were they thinking in asking me?
Well, you know, it's contrast.
It is contrast.
Yeah, a little
that's
bit.
Right.
Yeah.
It is definitely contrast.
He never wears a yellow dress.
He doesn't wear a yellow dress. He's got something to say, and I don't. So that's perfect.
No, it'll be fine.
Oh, it'll be fine.
Yeah. You could talk about your green issues. You've got the environmental house thing.
Yeah,
you?
Environmental house. Yes, right. I do. I have a house that's a greenhouse, as we like to say.
You grow your marijuana plants?
Yeah. I just get baked all the time.
Right.
It's perfect. No, it's, you know, it's environmentally friendly home, and so it's made out of...
bricks. Sorry. Go ahead.
You can't help yourself.
No, I'm so sorry. I'm such a jerk. It really is awful. It's true. I know. I just realized right there.
Really? Is that what you're like on dates and stuff? When you take girls out, you finish their sentences?
No, I just wrote a commercial. This is going well. We'll be right back. No, it's all right. No, tell me about the house.
It's made out of it's an environmentally sort of friendly house, an eco-friendly house. So it's made of sustainable woods, and it's got solar energy, and it is and I'm waiting for you to say something.
No, I'm listening.
And it's very cool, and we're very proud of it, and it's made of, even the tile is recycled carpet fibers.
Do you have one of those cars? Do you have the biodiesel car that smells farty?
Yeah.
Really?
We have a biodiesel truck and a biodiesel bug, and we have a hybrid car too.
Right, okay. So it's a hybrid of biodiesel and regular diesel.
No, it's really a hybrid.
It's a hybrid of a car and a leopard.
Yeah.
Right. Well, that leopard. Must be fast, and it can get up trees. So there you are. That's...
We're going on a safari, and we're taking it with us.
Well, you can. It's kind of a all self-contained safari. Talk about the green issues when you do the commencement speech.
Yeah,
that'd be good.
I think that's a good idea.
Yeah, because you can throw yourself behind that. You're living by that thing, and
okay.
Yeah.
Then what else am I going to talk about?
Well, you wear the yellow dress. No one will give a rat's ass. We'll be fine. We're out of time. Thank you so much for
bummer.
Coming. Yeah, I know. I'm sorry. Come back. Will you come back?
Yeah, I will.
All right, then. Julia Louis-Dreyfus, everyone. We'll be right back.